welcome everyone to the ongoing backstage activities of the new Cultural Center located at 84 Southeast 4th Avenue, once the home of Robert and Martha Butler. The Butler families were early pioneers in Deerfield Beach and supported the community in countless ways. Today and for the next few sessions, our goal is to show you with videos the behind-the-scenes actions of transforming this beautiful Butler home, their mid-century home, into the area's first cultural center. In order to do this, it involves neighbors, volunteers, board members, and small business owners to help.
Hi, I'm TJ Egan. I have lived in Deerfield Beach now for over 40 years. And I'm on the board here at the Historical Society, and I'm really excited about this project.
Judy here, and I'm a resident in Deerfield Beach since 1987. On the board, I'm the vice president, and I'm a worker bee. So let's get going today.
Hey, I'm Susan Davis. I've been in Deerfield since 1979, and I'm just a plain old worker bee.
I'm Barbara Friend. We first came to Deerfield in the early 50s. I was married in 57 in Pompano. And the Historical Society is doing such a great job, and this is my home. For many years, my family's home and my great-grandchildren's home.
Hi, my name's Dave Noterer. I'm on the board of the Historical Society, and I'm here to help today. I'm going to play cameraman today, though.
Hi, I'm Poppy Mercier, and I'm pretty much do whatever needs to be done and definitely excited about being part of this whole process of turning the house into a cultural center. So our ultimate goal is to take each one of the video segments and to have a cultural activity, planning, resident conversations, and in the end we're going to take each month and we'll have a very special artist that will be featured. And in July we're looking forward to Charles Colello coming to talk to us and maybe play for us some of his music. He's one of the original Four Seasons.
And now that you have met all of the worker bees, let's get started. So grab a box and let's head to the Grand Lounge to start our work day.
Hey, it's time to start.
It's time. Yes, it is. It's time. We call this Out with the Old, Get Ready for the New.
Here we are in the Grand Lounge, and we are preparing the room as a small theater. As I said, Charles Colello is going to be our first guest. And he is quite special, not only by being the Four Seasons, but he's a world-class conductor and producer and arranger. And if you've ever heard the words to Sweet Caroline, Sweet Caroline, bum, bum, bum.
Good time never seemed so good.
He's responsible for that. So we're looking forward to it. Now we're gonna say hello to Judy, and I know she's excited because we're gonna be talking about mid-century and decor and how we're going to transform this room. So here you go, Judy.
Don't you just love mid-century modern? I tell you, I grew up with it, some of it anyway. Ran from the 40s to the 70s, and it encompasses all kinds of designs. And we put together a little study, excuse me, about different designs and concepts we can use. The bones of the house are mid-century ranch. So we're going to put details here and there just to bring out that mid-century touch. You can go a couple of ways. You can go really bold, like a design like this, which I like. Or you could go a little more subtle, a little more versatile maybe, but then carry the theme through the home with just little touches to bring out that nostalgia. So when people come into the room, they go, oh my gosh, I remember that. So. No, enough talking, so we need to get started, and I think there might be something going on in the bedroom.
This is Studio B, and as we had showed you at the last episode, Studio A was for all the arts, for doing the actual art projects and painting, Studio B is a continuation of having small groups be able to meet, sharing their likes and also whatever kind of a hobby or crafts or such a thing as that. And for private instruction, I imagine a guitarist sitting here practicing their strums and their chords, and quite beautiful.
I'm TJ. I'm on the board of directors at the Deerfield Beach Historical Society. We are really blessed to have this opportunity to transform this beautiful home into what will be the first real true cultural center in Deerfield Beach. The challenge is huge. As you can tell, we've got a lot of work to do, but at the end of the day, we're going to end up with a beautiful community center that can be used for both performance art, art to be displayed in galleries, and a lot of education as well. So we're starting a really fun, incredible project, and I'm proud to be a part of it.
This is Studio C, and as you can see, it was one time one of the guest bedrooms. But as a studio, we will be having not only private instructions, small groups that would like to meet and share their likes and their crafts, and also act as a green room, so when we're having a performance in the Grand Lounge, that we will have a place for our artists to wait and prepare for their debut. David, come on in. I want to show you the space that's going to be the resource library. And
right.
Also our gallery, and people may not know it, but you're a fine photographer and have been well known for creating really interesting and exciting landscapes. So I thought maybe you could tell us a little bit about it, since he's going to probably be one of our first artists in September with his own show. So there you go.
Hi, Dave Noderer. I'm actually a software developer, but people around town think I'm a photographer because I walk on the beach every morning and I take these beautiful sunrises. It's not me, it's the subject for sure. But I do have thousands and thousands of somewhat unique pictures in some case. And so they've asked me to print some and display some, and we'll have a little art show when the time is appropriate.
This area is particularly exciting, not only if you were a homeowner and you wished your closet had this kind of space, but for the Historical Society, we have a wonderful collection, almost 5,000 pieces, and its storage and having proper storage is always a concern. So this will give us the opportunity to be able to put things in their proper place and to be able to keep them cool.
Come on in. How are you?
Oh, we're looking forward to this day. Thank
me
you.
Too. Me too.
Thank you, thank you,
How's
thank
everything?
You.
Good?
Yeah, everything's good.
You guys done a lot with the place. It looks beautiful.
Oh, we're going to get there. We're getting so excited about it.
Good.
But I wanted everyone to meet you because you're so special. And something that probably people don't realize is that your store, the Deerfield Thrift, is right on the corner, right around this corner on Hillsborough and 2nd Ave.
Yeah, we're all right in the Grove.
Yeah, that's right, Pioneer Grove.
Yeah, Pioneer Grove.
Yeah, and so we're really excited about that. And I thought maybe you might tell people just a little bit about yourself and what you're thinking about Pioneer Grove being so much a part of it, because you're at the entrance.
Well, it's the history of Deerfield. It's everything. These people are wonderful people. The historical site is top-notch. Deerfield's a great spot and growing. The Grove is going to be really a successful operation. I really think it's going to be nice. You know, I think it's going to be good. And I think it's going to bring a lot of people to Deerfield. This cultural center is going to be wonderful. This is going to be a great add-on. And it's going to be great for the community and for the Pioneer Grove and for everybody in Deerfield. I think it's wonderful. And so happy to help you guys out and be a part of it. Thank you for inviting me.
I think we've had it for the day. We have cleaned out the old and we're ready for the new. And until the next program, we want to say goodbye and thank you so much for helping us today. So, bye.
Bum, bum, bum.
Sweet Caroline.
Bum, bum, bum.
That's it.
Sweet Caroline.
Bum, bum, bum.
Sweet Caroline.
Sweet Caroline.
Hi, this is Charlie Colello. Like the coronavirus, this song has no barriers, and it's being sung all over the world. In the meantime, let's smile, stay healthy, be safe, until we can all sing together again.